Good morning everyone, this is Rohit Khurana. Today we are having chapter 1st of grade 8, Rational Numbers. Before starting this session, I would like to tell you the objectives of this chapter. Means at the end of this session, you will be able to define rational numbers. Means what are the rational numbers. Second, properties of rational numbers. What are the properties of rational numbers? Like we have done in the chapter 1st of grade 7 integers. Commutative properties, associative properties, closure properties. So all these properties we'll do here again. Next, word problems, means in daily routine where we're using word problem of related to rational numbers. Next is practical approach, mean our daily routine life where we are using rational numbers. After explaining the definition, I will tell you the practical approach. So should we start this chapter? Before the starting, let's have a recapitulation. In grade 6, grade 7, we have done so many definitions of the numbers in the number system chapter. First is your natural numbers. Again, I'm asking natural numbers. So the numbers which starts from 1 and goes to infinite are known as the natural numbers. Second, we are having whole numbers. If we are adding 0 to the natural numbers, it will become the whole numbers. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to infinite. These numbers are known as your whole numbers. Okay, first was a natural number. The numbers which starts from 1 and goes to infinite are known as your natural numbers. The numbers which starting from 0 and goes to infinite are known as the whole numbers. Tell me one question. Is 0 a natural number? Obviously no, because the natural number are starting from 1 only. Is 1 a natural number? Yes. Is 1 a whole number? Yes. So let's move to the third step, integers. In grade 7 you have done integers. What are integers? The collection of the whole number together with the negative numbers are known as your integers. The collection of the whole numbers together with the negative numbers are known as the whole numbers. We have done this in grade 7. First chapter is there, integers. Okay, so here two type of integers are there, 1 to infinite, like this, 1 to infinite, these are known as the positive integers, and minus 1 to minus infinite, these are known as the negative integer. So the question is here, what is 0? What is the sign we put in front of 0? 0 is neither negative nor positive, it's just an integer. Okay, so 0 is just an integer. It was the recapitulation that we have done in grade 6 and 7 so that we can do our chapter rational numbers. Let's have an introduction of the rational numbers, that what are the rational numbers. So we proceed towards the definition. Rational numbers, the numbers which can be expressed in the form of P upon Q, where Q is not equal to 0 and P and Q are the integers. Remind that the number which can be written in the form of P upon Q and Q should not be equal to 0 and P and Q are integers. For example, 3 upon 4. What is the value of P here? 3. 3 is an integer. What is the value of 4 here? Q. Q is an integer. So these are the integers. Integers can be negative also. Integers can be positive also. So there are the rational numbers. It can be positive also, it can be negative also. You will remind one thing in your mind, that the number which we are expressing in the form of P upon Q, this Q, this denominator should not be equal to 0. If it will become to equal to 0, it will become not defined. Tell me one question. Is 1 upon 3 is a rational number? Yes, it's a rational number. Is 5 minus 5 upon 7 a rational number? Yes, it is a rational number. Is minus 1 upon 8 a rational number? Yes. Is plus 1 upon 8 a rational number? Yes. One question. Is 3 a rational number? Most of the time, the students are confused in this kind of questions. Is 3 a rational number? Think and then give me the answer. Is 3 a rational number? You will say, sir, it's 3 only. So there is not P is equal to 3, then what is Q here? Q is 0. No, 3 we are given, then then we can take them as denominator as 1. So 3 upon 1, 3 and 3 upon 1 is the same thing. So 3 upon 1 can be written as a rational number. 3 upon 1 is a rational number. 5 is a rational number. Yes, minus 5 is a rational number. Yes, because the denominator will be 1. My last question of this introduction, is 5 upon 0 a rational number? If you have learned the definition properly, then you will give the answer in a few seconds. Like, is 5 upon 0 a rational number? No, obviously no, because this q is 0. But we have learned in the definition the numbers which can be expressed in the form of p upon q, and q should not be equal to 0, but here q is 0. So 5 upon 0 is not a rational number. So you must know, after this topic we'll do the properties, but you must learn the definition of the rational number. What are rational number? The numbers which can be represent in the form of p upon q and q not equal to 0, where p and q are integers. Very good.